me kicking y'all in the face right now. I don't believe in spousal abuse, but you need to learn the lesson on letting men go and letting men regret their decisions. Okay, well, let me start my intro. What's going on, everybody? It's your favorite dating coach. Got to get into routine here. Elliot Scott, and as you can see by the title below, we are going to talk about getting men to regret their decision, okay? Now, let me know what you think about that intro. Not my kicking. You don't like that, probably, but the actual intro. Let me know what I can change. I might change the music. But I had a session with a client, just finished it, and I have to say, ladies, that when a guy... Not when he's afraid to lose you, but when a guy is taking you for granted and you know it is very clear, there needs to be a consequence for his actions. So this guy and girl were talking for a bit, and they got in an argument about commitment, even though she didn't bring it up. And he basically was ripping her a new one, saying, hey, if you're looking for a relationship, I'm not the guy right now. If you want to keep talking and seeing where things go, okay, cool. But if you're wanting a relationship right now, I'm not that guy. And she feels that she's the one always initiating, that she's the one always reaching out and doing the work and things like that. And so she asked me, well, should I pull away or should I reach out? And I'm like, why would you reach out? You just told me that you're the one always reaching out. You're tired of it. So don't do it, right? I know, smart. But then I gave her a long laundry list on, and here's the important concept, ladies. A lot of you will listen to, like, you would do what I do with my hypochondria, okay? I would go to a therapist and I would tell him that I think I have this. And he'd be like, so, and I'll tell him the whole details, the ins and outs and why I think this and why I don't think I have it and stuff like that. And so he would say, you think you have this, you know, but you're giving me all this evidence over here that you don't, but you're holding on to this one little thing that says you do, right? And women do the same thing with a lot of men in relationships because you have rose-colored glasses and because you like the guy so much. You know, you're like, well, he's a nice guy and I have this great chemistry with him or whatever the thing is. But then there's this long laundry list on reasons why you shouldn't do it, such as him not wanting a relationship, him maybe just getting out of one. He doesn't treat you right. He's not an initiator. He doesn't communicate well. You fight often. You can't. He doesn't put effort in as much as you would like. Whatever the reason is, but with this client, I give her a long laundry list, and you need to listen to this, lady, so you can let go of men too, on why she should not initiate. This guy is already not initiating, so he is taking advantage of her and the power that he has. He's taken her for granted. He thinks he has her, which is why he's not reaching out. I always talk about this offensive and defensive dating approach. Offensive is the one that we're all used to, which is we're talking consistently and it's progressing towards a relationship, right? It's more offensive. It's just you and I just hit shooting shit and we like each other. Let's move it forward. Then there's the defensive, which is, man, I need to take this girl off the market. Because if I don't, someone else will. Like, I really like her, and if I lose my opportunity, I'm going to regret it. But that's the thing, though. None of you guys give a man an opportunity to regret it. So I tell clients this. Like, if a guy is treating you... If a guy's not putting forth the effort, if a guy's not initiating... I'm not saying he has initiated all the time, but if he's not genuinely interested, you could tell, okay? You could tell... Then he's not afraid of losing you. And if he's not afraid of losing you, then there's either a lack of attraction or he feels like he has you. So reaching out in my client's sense does not make sense, okay? I also told her that if you sign up and say, I'll reach out to him, and you start reaching out and going along with things again, that's a renegotiation that's going to favor him. Because if he says, I don't want a relationship, okay, and you continue to talk to him, well, then you must be okay with friends with benefits. Otherwise, why are you reaching out, right? Why are you renegotiating? What she should say is, hey, I understand, we're looking for different things, it seems, or maybe at a different pace, no disrespect, I'm just going to bow out. If you change your mind, let me know. No rush. Again, I know you're not looking for something, and just give them the whole spiel, and then get out, right? And now, women might be trying to justify her actions or your own actions in this, if you're in a similar situation, by saying, well, he said, let's take it slow. He said he's kind of open to one, just not right now. That is man code for I'm buying time to get these assets. I want access to the assets. Because you always have to look at it from an advantage, a man's advantage, or like a perspective, right? So if I'm not wanting a relationship, it doesn't mean you don't have assets. I just don't want that lifestyle of a relationship. I want you and the assets you offer. So I'm not just going to cut you off. I'm going to take advantage of these assets, and I'm going to do it for however long. And then by the time, because again, you're hoping I want to, or you're hoping I come, you know, come around and say, yeah, I do want a relationship. You're hoping for that later down the road, but that's X months later. Why would I commit to you? I'm getting everything I already want right now. I'm getting it all right now. I would actually lose out on things by dating you because right now I'm in the best situation. I can have my cake and eat it too, but by dating you, I have to give up all these other women for something I'm already getting from you, right? Now, it sounds like I'm yelling, which I guess I am, but I'm not upset, so I don't know why my action or my words aren't lining up, or my actions and emotions aren't lining up with my my feelings, because I'm chill. But you get what I'm saying, okay? Ladies, you gotta make a man regret his decision. I'm not saying cut a man off right away. I'm not saying be impulsive and just say, hey, you know, at the first sign of danger, you're like, I'm done. It has to be a pattern. If you can tell that you're holding on more to emotion than facts, right? Like if he's just not showing it over time, and you're only holding on because you're hoping something changes, it's time to let this motherfucker go, okay? Oh, sorry. Damn, goddamn it, YouTube. Sorry, YouTube. That being said, ladies, I love you. Take care. If you have not yet, please subscribe. If you want to work with yours truly, link down below. Attraction Academy down below. Let me know what you think about the introduction. I love you, ladies. Take care and peace.